Good morning, everyone. Good afternoon, good evening, wherever you're watching from at this hour. Today is the 1st of October, 2021. It's the start to a new month, and I hope our month will be profitable. And also, it's the end to a trading week, and I hope our week has been profitable thus far. So this morning, I'm not going to be doing much of the talking. We're going to be doing the talking on a chart. I'm going to be analyzing the chart and also analyze the chart that was sent out last week and this week, and let's see how what actually played out. And also, I'm going to be analyzing the chart, a peak that I'm in, because we've seen the noise and the in the news. It's, I think, since last week up to this week, and which has really impacted the market. And also, now you see why I always say you need to merge your fundamentals with technical and the market tune. So then you know what moves the market, because you can't just stick to technical alone. One fundamental can crumble your technical. So this morning I will be showing you also, so we can have a discussion. Then you see why I always say, and then you know why I always fight against the robotic signal. It doesn't work. So once this peak, I'm going to show you about the S&P 500, because I was so much glued to the TV yesterday to see if the House of Representatives will be making that vote, which didn't happen last night. So it impacted the market. So I'm going to show you. So we won't be doing much of the talking. We'll be focusing on the chart. And so now you know why I always say robotic signal don't work. But yesterday I got a call from the US. Someone was asking me about one robotic signal that is, I told them no, robotic signal doesn't work. It has never worked. It's never going to work. A robot cannot predict what's going to happen in the market. So there's just those people selling robotic signal are trying to survive. And the only way they can survive is through you, because now they have already failed. I keep saying that they have failed as a trader. So they are more focused now on developing any link and then calling it robotics. People are giving it even the names now. they have exhausted the name. This one will call snipers, killers, robot. Some will call it space, this one, the names are all, everything is being, they are killing it, they are killing everything, and they know it doesn't work. So I'm going to be showing you this morning, so you see why I'm always against these people. And also, the last video I did, that was it 2 days ago, 3 days ago, regarding how to be consistent in the market. I got a lot of me, they wanted me to speak on the part two, but I'm not going to be speaking on the part two today. Maybe by next week, I will speak on the part two, so you know how to be consistent in the market. I became so consistent in the market, and what I do and what I know that makes my bias more stronger than yours. So let's dive in now. We're just going to first of all go to the peak that I don't know if you remember the last one, the US oil. I told you guys when we analyzed that today, I'm already out of this peak. It didn't actually hit a deep, but got close to. So I just closed the position because of the noise that was going around and all that. So I closed the position. So we're going to go over to that one first. Then we'll come to this week peak. Then I will show you what I said I was going to show you with the S&P 500 and all that. So you know that fundamentals move the market. So we're going to share the screen now. Then we'll take it from there. Just give me 1 minute. Let me pull these stuffs out. Just give me 1 minute. Let me pull them out so we can kickstart. Yes. Okay, this one. Let's see. It's this one. So let me first of all, this one is the one, the Aussie US, let me pull out. Sorry, just give me some minute. So you see why I told you people, this robot guys, the reason why I'm always happy when I do this is because I don't maybe say something now and then, or say something that has already happened. I do it, like that's what I always tell you. If these people say they know what they're doing, right? Cool. Let them analyze the chart, like on a Monday, like we do, analyze the chart, post it out, and say, this is what I believe is going to happen, right? Then, on the weekend, let's come back and see if actually what you said actually came to pass. That's how to know a good trader. Not that you are doing a replay of what has already happened. No, it does. Anyone that has the market knowledge, or even an amateur can even analyze and say, oh, this is the chart that he gave me. It has already happened. The market has also, this place. No, anyone can do it. So I want you to, when you're looking for people that you want to give your money to, that you say, okay, tell them to analyze the chart. I'm not here to ask you to subscribe to any of my destination. Okay, follow us on Instagram, follow us on Facebook, like and share, subscribe to our YouTube channel. That's all. I analyze the chart and I tell you, look what I was looking at. And that gave my bias, gave me my strong bias to say, okay, yes, we are having an opportunity. We are having a downward trend. Oh, I don't know the direction of the market. There are some market that, some chart that I see, it's very confusing to me that sometimes I don't even know the direction where the market is going to. So I don't force the market. That's why I actually don't fight the market. Don't force the market. Let the market play out whatever it wants to. So if I see some chart that I don't know what is going on now, there's been a struggle. I just wait and allow the market play out and see if I will spot maybe a pattern, maybe like a bullish pattern that will now build up. Maybe on it, I can just leave it go on a higher time and look for like the pattern that will build up, and then that will give me my bias to say, okay, yes, let me go in now, or let me still wait. Waiting with patience in the market is very, very important. There are some peak you see, don't force it. That's why I say, someone said, price action. That's the only strategy in the market. You don't even know what you're saying, because there are some market you can use price action for. There are some things that will crumble technical. There are some news in the market that will crumble tech. So once you are coming into trading, you need to know that, yes, you need to have that mindset. Like I always say to you, guys, have the mindset of, yes, I want to come and learn. I want to come and learn. I need to be alert to any news that will come up that might crumble my analysis, so that I might quickly retrace. Like the last one of the message I did was the Bayesian analysis, that you have to merge the recent data with the current previous data with the recent data. And then you are still waiting and hoping for any other data that becomes available that might intrude and encroach into the market and change the direction of the market. That was what even happened when I opened the US oil. That was this last week. I told you guys, I came back. You can go and watch the video. When we got to close to hitting TP, I just closed it. It was on a daily time frame. So when we got to hitting TP, I closed it. I said, no, let me, because the noise was just too much. The negativity around the market was just too much. Investors, they were scared, skeptical about the news and all that, and what was playing out in China. And then we've seen that in the House of Representatives in the US, and all the noise and the market, the Fed announcement and all that, the noise was just too much. So it was affecting the US trade. So with that alone, you know that there are some peak. We had like, this week we had like, there was some, I think we didn't trade much this week. We had some free account that we did not open because the noise was just too much. And we didn't know where the market was heading to. Well, then we saw it for this, like the peak I did, when I say peak, is on, you know, same position. I took the same position because S&P 500 was defiling and all the support because of the news. Investors, first of all, they were very skeptical. Everyone was pulling out. We saw the market was tanking and all that. So you all these pieces of puzzle, put them there, you now put them together, then you see the pieces of puzzle, then you now get a complete balance, a trading, what's it called, knowledge. Have a balance, not just you focus on one alone. No, it doesn't work. So let's go now. Let me, first of all, we'll go now to check the US oil. Then we'll come and let me share the screen. This is my personal screen. Are we now? Screen 2, 4. Hope you can see this. I like this thing the way it is now because it's just tiny up there. Think that people are not going to see me. So this was the scan that was sent out. If you go to our Instagram, like what I always say, this is not a guesswork. You can go and verify yourself. You can go to our Instagram page, you can go to our Facebook page, and you see then that it was posted, the day it was posted. And if even if you, maybe you can say, well, maybe it's doing the replay, okay, you can check the day it was posted and then go on your own, on your own chart, and check that day where the market was, so that you understand where the candle was. So you see that yes, this thing was 100%. So this was the US oil that was posted. If you see the date here on the tradingview.com, it was September 20th, 2001 at 06 UCT. So what we said was going to happen. Okay, let's go to our Instagram page. Let me refresh. Because the reason why I don't analyze it, I check it here because I cannot zoom out. So it's a little bit difficult for me. So if we go, what's this thing? Profile. So let's go now to profile. If we go now, this one, let me take this one now to the side. This was when it was posted. On the 20th of September, you can see the date here on Instagram. Go to our Instagram page, go to our Facebook page, go what was posted on the 20th. So if I go now, this is the edited when we edit the chart. So what I said, I told you guys, I saw a spotted pattern building up from here. This was a support zone, expected the support zone, and then we saw it violated this broke out from the support zone. So this was a key area of interest for me. And then we saw now, when this was a key area for me, then we now saw a fall, right? We saw a fall downside. Then we saw it was respecting this level now as resistant support. Then it broke out from this area. So this place now becomes a very key area for me. Then we saw, let me take this one. I'm just going to remove this picture. So now we saw a continuation. After we saw a breakout from this level, we saw a continuation down, and then this place we saw a support zone here. I wanted to test it twice, support zone. Then we saw another support zone here. This place here, this area here was, and we spotted an inverted hammer at this level that signaled a fall. So immediately we got here. Did not it didn't sound like a mistake. So it formed an imp because it was on a daily time frame. So I was watching, then when I saw the support, the first candle close here, then the next candle now formed. They now formed a piercing line. This piercing line now gave me my confirmation that we are seeing an upward trend to obviously, first of all, struggle at this level. Then you see, to struggle at this level, then we cannot see a continuation. So the market was trading at this level. So I said I was expecting a pullback to activate our entry. So our entry got, we now did a pending order to activate our entry at this level where my mouse cursor is right now. I hope you can see it. So if you see what I said, a long position above 66.4 zero calls for a further uptrend with target at 73.98 and 77.17 in extension. And I wrote, this was my pending a pullback. So I was expecting a pullback. So if we go to the live market now, this was the scan that was sent out on 20th of September. So we're seeing this with the scan. So if we go now to the live market now to see what actually played that. So this is what actually played that now. We're expecting a pullback. Like I said, if you remember, I told you guys our position got activated the next day with this candle right here. With this candle, we saw a pullback. Maybe it got activated here. Then we now saw a continuation now to go it immediately hit this close to this TP. I told you quite close our position here. It was almost hitting TP. Then we now saw a fall now to struggle at this level now. So I'm still waiting because of the news that is flying out. If I spot maybe a pattern builds up here, that's why I had to circle this area. If I spot the pattern building up, because I can see like there's a pattern building up here also again, it's trying to form. See, it's trying to form another piercing line that will maybe seeing that this look like Angry Doge. So I'm going to wait to see anything that builds up there in the coming days. Then we'll see if we are going to continue to go eat 77.1 7. So yeah, we almost did. We already hit TP1, just the TP2. But I wasn't more focused on this TP1. I was focused on the TP2 because this is on the daily time frame, mind you. It's on the daily time frame. You can see here. So like I said, also we made a lot of pip from this peak. So now let's go. Now this was the US oil. You can see it for yourself. You can go to our Instagram page or Facebook page to go see what actually played that and when it was posted. So now we're going to go now to, let me stop this share now. So go to the other one. Let me stop. So now let's go to the let's check the go through the other one, and I will show you what I said. I was going to, what screen is this one again? So you can see that was the oil. So let's share the screen again and go to the one of repeat today. Sorry, let me just make sure these things. Let me just share the screen again. So is it this one? This one for, sorry. So let me quickly just, I'm trying to get to this new verification code now. Let me quickly run this one. So, 5, 7. Okay. So yeah, that is it. So let me share the screen now so you see what I have been saying, and you know what moves the market, so you don't fall for these guys that wants to say robotic signal. You see this book, someone called me, I was asking me about the robotic signal. Straight up, it doesn't work. People said I'm spoiling their business, but that's the truth. So if we go now to the one that was posted this week, which was on the 26th, sorry, 27th, you can see here on of September 2021, this was the Aussie USD. So what I said, you see, this is the chart. This is not the live market now. So I just want us to go through the chart first, then we'll go to the live market to see what actually played out. So you see what I said here. There was let me just put this one here. There was a key area of interest that I spotted at this level of support and this level of resistance, this level, these two trend line here, and then sorry, this horizontal line to horizontal line here, and then this became my, I said it in the chat because, like I always tell people, I like to detail my chart. I don't just post and then, you know, I like to detail my chart so that even you guys, you're going to, you can easily read it and say, okay, look at what he's saying, look at what he's saying. That is what I do. I detail my chart to the core. So I know what I'm doing. I know what I'm saying. I know what I saw, and I know how I'm Because one, if you if what you can easily describe and explain what you've seen, what you saw, and what you think is going to happen. So I try to detail my chart so that I'll tell you this is what I saw and this is what I expect the market to play. So now you see, I wrote here, this is what my key area of interest, and this area as well, and this area as well that has acted as support and also resistant in the past. So now I spotted a Twizza top invalidation at this level on the daily time frame that signaled that here we are having a fall. So what I said was going to happen on this chart, if you can see, my camera is here, but I'm not because my screen is here. Sorry. I wasn't expected a straight a continuation dance. What I expected was a pullback, right? So a continuation down to go test at this level of which I said was my key area of interest. Then I was expecting a breather, a pullback also to this level, also to touch base on this level, which was as acted as support and resistance before. Then before I will expect a fall to go hit RTP. This was what I said. You can go to our Instagram page. Let me go to our Instagram page. This was what was posted. You can go there today and see the line, how I drew my line and what I expected was going to happen and all that. This is there. It was posted on the 27th, excuse me, of September 20. Twenty twenty one. So you can go there, go to our Instagram page, go to our Facebook page, and you can see it there. I don't do what's it called? Let's do a replay. So now let's see what actually played out. This now is the live market scan, like I said. So the market was here, and also if you, we also did a pending order because I was expecting. If you see what you go now, you saw I drew a line at this level, not this one. You saw I drew a line at this level. This was where I was expecting to get into the market. So we also did a pending because, like I told you guys, I don't just one thing I don't do. I don't see a market, then I'll just dive in. No, you don't know what you're doing. What I normally do is once I analyze the chart, right? Analyze the chart. For me, my bias to be more stronger, what I do is I don't, I always have orders are always pending order, always pending order. I know when to get into the market. I know when to expect a pullback to go eat, activate our entry. So what we do is we always do a pending order. So if you see here at this level, I drew a line. This is the chart that I was saying, this is not a live market. So if you go to the live market now to actually see what happened. So we saw this was when this, so our position got activated at this level. Yeah, we did depending on that because I was expecting it to at least get to this level too before we can see a momentum to build. And so if you see what actually happened, so our position got activated, yeah, right? At this level, yeah, it was this candle that activated our entry, this bullish candlestick. That was this is on the 1 hour time frame, yeah. This was the candle that activated our it was the next day as well that we got activated. It was at I think it was at I got to the office and I saw that our position was already activated. I think it was late at night, the next day. So our position got activated. Then it did a little continuation down upside, and then I would not saw a continuation downside. Right? We saw now I actually expected it to play to come touch base at this level, which I said before was my key area of interest. Can you see now? So we saw a continuation down to come touch base here at this level. We saw a struggle, struggle, struggle. And then what I said next was going to happen was I expected a pullback to come as well, touch base at this level because this area are my key area of interest and it's very what's it called? Is my pivotal area of my is very pivotal to what I was expecting. So I expected the market continuation to pull back. So if you see what actually played, I saw a continuation downside to hit this level, which I expected it to do. And then we now saw what a continuation upside to actually go expect this level again. Then before we now saw a full straight down. You see what I'm saying now? So this is not a guesswork. This is not what you do with. No, this is not a guesswork. This what someone that's intelligent in the market that is able to merge his fundamental with his technical and then expecting, waiting for the market to. So just imagine that what we said is, let me zoom in so that I expected a continuation downside, right? To hit this level, respect this level. Then what I said again, I said I expected a pullback upside to go test at this level. Then I expected it, I did a straight down TP. Just took now. Immediately we hit our TP now at this level. We now saw a rejection down upside, and then we're seeing a pullback down. I expect it again to bounce at this level, but because we are already out of the market, we are positioned, we are out of the market here. So we're seeing a play now. I don't really know what's going to happen here because I expected a TP too. But what we're seeing, if we see a bounce again here, if I see a bounce, a rejection here, a support here again, then and another rejection again at this level. No, at this level, I expect a rejection at this level. Yeah, then I might expect to break out from this level to go ETP2. So that will be for next week. Next week, so we'll see what will play out on this trend. So if you see now, this analysis is detailed. You can go to our Instagram page, it's there. It's not that I did something, then later will not. No, I don't do that. If you know what you're doing, you sure just go and analyze the chart. Then let people see what you've analyzed. Don't keep it. And don't, you see, so let me just show this. So you see, it gets to a stage because where you are able to, once you get to that stage where you're able to, because that was one thing I learned from my mentor. That's how you build your confidence. When you are able to, it's not easy. It's not easy for you to analyze the chart and post it out. Your reputation is at stake. You understand? Because what if it doesn't play out? That's why these people are scared. Because they know they are not a trader. They don't know what they are looking for in the market. I know what I'm looking for in the market. And once I see the opposite, that's why you see in all my charts. Let me go back. In all our chart that we send out, you'll notice that I always have scenario two, which is very important to me because I know what I'm looking for. Once the scenario two, I know where my stop loss is supposed to be at, so that once my it gets to that level, I know we are out of the market. So nine, let's say nine out of 10. If you have a win ratio like that, and because at the end of the day, like I always say to people, what we're doing in the market is purely based on majority of decision we take in the market is based on probability. Probability. The reason why my probability is stronger than yours is because I'm able to merge my fundamentals with my technical in the market, so I'm able to take from the new, the old, and then to the new, and then merge it with the new data. Then I'm still hoping and waiting for any data that becomes available at that time, so I can also what adjust my level. That's the Bayanza analysis. So maybe I will speak on that again because I remember someone said they love the analysis. If I can elaborate more, but I will see what we will do. So now you see what I just analyzed. This is not a guesswork. So if those people that are saying yes, let them. I'm never available for those kind of people. Anyways, they can keep on deceiving themselves and deceiving those that wants to be deceived. So, what I can do is to speak. What? So if you see now what I said, this is the live market. Market is going on now. So we saw like it's not. I remember someone said, he said, how did you know it was going to play out like that? Because if you see the arrow I drew, I expected the continuation downside. This was posted, if you can see on the trading view, it was posted, what's it called? On the 27th of September, 0 UTC. So which is about, I remember it was 6, then it was 9. 9:30 because they are the UCT is the South African time. They are I think the UCT is South African time is 2 hours ahead of. So if it is 6:37 here, then it will be on this trading view, then it will be 9:37 South African time. So That was when the chat was posted out. So because if you go now to our Instagram page, you see if I go here now, oh, it doesn't show time. I wanted to see if it shows. And it was posted on the 27th. So you see, we analyzed it and then we came back and you saw what actually played. That is not a guesswork. I see, put continuation downside, I pull back continuation to go eat our TP. So this was posted when? On the 27th, we got our TP, we hit our TP when? Let me zoom in so we can see. So this, it was this candle that it closed out, I think it was on the 29th of September. That was when we got out of the market. We entered on the 27th. We got out of the market on the 29th of September at about 5 a.m., which was 17 of, which is 5 p.m., and it will be 7 p.m. South African time. So that was when we got out of the market on the 29th of. So this is what I analyzed and this is what I sent out. So now let's go now to the S&P 500 that said I was going to analyze to you guys. So we see what is actually going on. This now is crumbling now. The technical is not due to fundamental. I already took a sell position on this since I think this week we took a sell position and it's doing great. We are doing well. Because, you know, if you remember, I said when we're trading at this level, I expected we're going to see, what's it called, a golden cross at this level. It was already building a golden cross at this level. And I told you guys, I said, I was expecting the golden cross to confirm at this level or at this level that will now signal maybe we'll have a buy position. So now, here again, we see where you've been able to know what's going to happen. And patient with the market. So I told you guys, I said, I was waiting for if I spot a confirmation at this level of a golden cross, at this level, then we'll signal a buy. The golden cross was where, what was it called? When the 250 exponential moving average crosses, so that was my signal. If you see when it saw was a dead cross, that we saw here that not signal before it was not trading above. So if we're spotting that it was going to have another cross here to not start trading, it was trading below now to not start trading above this 50 and 200 EMA, then that would not signal if, a continuation upside. So when it violated it here due to some fundamental that crept into the market with this Evergrande a collapse in China, and then investors, they were very skeptical, and then we saw a fall. So it started building up again to go, and then it formed a golden cross here again. I wasn't even aware of this golden cross, but I wasn't even checking because it was a free fall. So when I spot a golden cross here again, a golden cross, then trading, then now violated, it was, yeah, and I saw and I spotted that, yes, there's, it was everything that clicked for me. At this level, that was when we now did a position where we now spotted the dead cross here at this level, because now it was the fundamental was not clear when the US also the Fed and they were not straightforward with what they were saying and all that. So now we now spotted a dead cross at this level now. That was when we now signal a buy a sell position here at this level, because now it was not trading below the 200, below the 50, below the 21, and below the 80 exponential moving average. So that now gave us a bias for a sell position, because now this was not now a dead cross. So enough for the technical now made the fundamental with what's going on around the news and all that, and the government shutdown that the investors were skeptical about. We're happy now that they were able to reach an agreement for the shutdown in the US. And now, the what's it called, the 3.5 trillion infrastructure bill in the US now, they are on a stalemate now. The negotiation is breaking up. We're expecting a vote yesterday, which didn't happen because the Senate representative, the guy that is against it now, he said he wants 1.5 trillion and all that and all that. So they tuned in now, investors now. That's what I always tell you, the psychology that links all the investors and the traders, the intelligent one, together, that when something is playing out, They are all taking the same decision at the same time without them even knowing, without them, without them, they are not in the same geographical location, but they are taking the same decision. Why? Because there's this, the intelligent investors are linked together psychologically. They are linked together psychologically. So now we now saw now, when they spotted a dead cross at this level, now it was not trading evaluated. This one is the 8, this one is the 21, this one is the 50, and then this one is the 200 exponential moving average. Now we now spotted, now you see, we saw a fall now. So yes, we saw now, this is what I wanted to show you now. See, now we saw this was the support zone that it respected before. You see the support zone here, right? That's how I analyze my market. I like to do it. So if you spotted the support zone here, you respected it here, it bounced here, and then it went up a little bit, did a bit as if it was going, having a, it was a confirmed, what's it called? A support. Then we saw a quick out from this support zone, right? Now to continuation downside. So our next support to target now will be here. So will be at this level, which is 4232.20. So this is where I'm expecting now to take my profit first, then I will see another setup. If we now break the support now, because this is going to be our next support zone, this 4232.20, this is our next target now, because I've already broken through this support zone, which it has respected before. See here, yeah, at this level. Support here. And you also did support and also resistance on this level. So now our next support zone now will be where? At this level. At this level 4.2. Our next level now 4232.20. That will not be our next support target now to, where is it? That will not be our next target. So if it breaks through again, this violates this support zone, our next target now will be support target now will be 4062. If you can see, I already typed all this thing. I'm following the market. That's why I always tell people, be patient with the market. The market is not your mate that you want to fight with. The market is not your mate that you want to fight with. Be patient with the market. That if the only way you can be patient in the market is when you know what you're doing, right? That's the only way you can be patient with the market, when you know what you're doing. And how do you become that confident and then have that knowledge and awareness in the market? Is by learning. It's by learning. It's not by plugging robotics now that doesn't work. Robotics now, you see what I analyze now. We are seeing the fall now. There might be a bounce at that level, then I'll take my profit quickly and then we'll see what happens. Because one fundamental set that can even creep in, maybe by the open bell of trading with today, might even, we will see a rejection on that one news can just look at now. Maybe they just agree on the 3.5 trillion infrastructure bill now. And they pass the vote and they get that. You see, investors now are not comfortable and they can, would be the buyers now cannot take over again. But now the sellers are taking over because people are skeptical, people are afraid, people are scared. Because where you, we are told you last time, where your treasure is, where your treasure is, there your heart will also be. Your heart is always where your treasure. So people are skeptical. It's better for me to pull out first and leave my money there to see, okay, well, let me see what plays out. That's what intelligent investors do. But the unintelligent one is still there. Doesn't know what is happening. It's opening the trade and it's going out. Maybe someone is even doing a buy position. It's going out. You're coming. You're going out. At the end of the day, you blow your account because why? You're not knowledgeable. You don't know what is going on in the market. And that's what I always advise people. So if you see what I just analyzed now, maybe more of the time we'll be doing more of the analysis. So subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Instagram, send your comment, let me know what you think about this video, what you want me to speak about more that can be of immense benefit to people, the young traders that are coming, because like I said, I want us to build an environment of intelligent people, not just people that are interested in what is not. They are wasting their time. Wasting your time, wasting your effort, wasting your money and all that. At the end of the day, you are depressed and all that. So let's come together, build intelligent people that are intelligent, that wants to learn, Because once you get the knowledge, then you see all these things that I'm saying now become very easy. You think it's easy, then you'll be making money then at least. Once you come into the market with the right mentality, with the right mindset of let me go and learn first, then at the end of the day, you see yourself, you will not be consistent in the market and you make profit. But if you come in with the mindset of I want to go and take the money now, then you will now bypass the learning process, which is very dangerous to and suicidal to an individual, to a trader, to go into the market with the aim of I just want to go and make the money now, not going into the market to say, okay, let me learn first. Then once I have learned this thing, then I believe that, yes, I will become consistent, then I will be profitable. So that was the right mindset. Come in to learn, then learn, keep on learning. Learning process doesn't stop with you just knowing one strategy. Like one guy said, there is only one strategy in the market. No. I'm just going to teach you. No, there's no, you don't have different strategy in the market. The one that works for you doesn't mean it will work for someone else. So these people, I don't know what they are eating. Maybe there's something that they are taking that's affecting their brain or something. Maybe it's possible. Maybe there's something that they are taking that is it's not good for them. So maybe they need to stop. It's better they stop it so that they can think well. So we have a lot of strategy in the market. Don't say we have one strategy. So we keep on learning. Like the last, the last video I did, I need to speak on the, you have to get the standard deviation. Like I told you, or maybe like next week, I'm going to show you, they will pay it. The standard, we get a standard deviation of one peak, they will pay it with another so that you see, if this market is this, if this peak is so much volatile, you cannot deal with it. Then you know, okay, this one is not that volatile. I can be trading. Then you have a rest of mind. You are trading gradually. You are making the little profit you're making. Then that's how you now grow your confidence in the market. Then before you see yourself now, you are now large. You have big account. You have a large account. Then that's so. If you are trading, if maybe I have an account of let's say $100,000. And I'm trading NASDAQ of S&P 500. I have a very big margin. I have a very big margin. Maybe I can even trade with leverage. Then I'll say to you, I have an account of, I just opened an account with a position on NASDAQ or S&P 500. Then you go and open a position with NASDAQ. Like I always say, if you have, there are some account that you need, you have, you don't need, you know, you don't need to be trading on some instruments. You need to know what is good for you at that time, based and due to your account size. Know that you are following people that don't even know what they are doing. Someone tells you that he's trading NASDAQ on a demo account. You are not aware. He opens a big position. Maybe he opens a demo account and funds the demo account with $100,000. He has a very big margin. So we can open and trade on a demo account without you knowing. It's not showing you a demo account, it's just showing you, you know, you that have, let's say, $1,000, $2,000, $5,000 account, you are not going to trade on a NASDAQ or S&P 500 or Dow. So you see, you there's no balance there. So once you know the account size, you know what you're trading on. You can have one peak, one currency pair. Okay, you're trading on currency pair that I'm not that volatile, and then you've seen that's when, what's it called, the price action now comes in. So you need to merge everything together so you can have a balanced trading environment. So you miss your, you know what, how that maybe. Account size. So maybe next week we'll speak on that when you know, okay, other standard. Deviation. So what we'll do now, maybe next we'll speak on standard deviation. Then we'll speak on well, I'll speak on standard deviation, price action, and account size. So we'll now merge everything together so that you know if how to calculate a standard deviation of Foucault, and then price action, you know that price action to know how to go on price action and your account size. So you now merge it. If I have an account size of this, I need to check the standard deviation of different equipment to know, okay, maybe like last 2 years, last 3 years of this, get a standard deviation of, it's going to be tedious. That's why you need to know. You will get a standard deviation of maybe a particular instrument for the past 5 years. You will now get the standard deviation of this particular instrument for the past 5 years. Then you now merge it together. Do not compare them together to see, okay, which one is more volatile? Okay, this one is less volatile. Okay, let me go on this one. Then you now go on that one, and you will not get go on the price actually go on a higher time frame now to check where the market direction is and what has happened in the previous in previous years to see where the market position is now. Okay, then you now go on lower term to go and try and see if you can, if there's a position you can open or you can scale. Then you not you acting now like a scalper in the market, but then you already know the where the market direction is going, but you're not coming in. Then what you need to be doing is, maybe let's assume you now say, okay, immediately I know the market is on the bullish trend now. Like, you know, now maybe you have gone on the higher time frame to, okay, this market is on the bullish trend, and you've seen where you're expecting a rejection, or maybe to the other where we are expecting a rejection at this level. Then what you do now, you say, okay, maybe I'm expecting a rejection at this level, maybe 4,000 or let's say 0.8752, this thing at that level. That's where we know we are expecting a rejection, and maybe the market is still trading below. Now what you do now, you know we are having a bullish trend. Then what you now do is, maybe you say, okay, anytime I spot a bullish engulfing pattern build, because on a lower time frame we can have a four. So what you say, if I spot a bullish engulfing pattern build there, I will buy again. Then maybe you use your Fibonacci retracement. I taught you put the way I use my Fibonacci retracement level to draw my line and all that. Maybe you use a Fibonacci retracement level to set a pending order. Once you see a pullback to that level, you activate, then you take your profit, then you scale through, go back to price action again. The higher time frame, check again. Yeah, we are still going, we're still going until we get to that stage. Because there's a lot of pairs in the market that you can pair with. So there's a lot of opportunity. The reason why you are not spotting your opportunity is because you are lazy. You don't want to put in the hard work. Like I always say, I say, put in the hard work, put in the hard work, put in the hard work. That's one of my slogans. If you know, that's one of my slogans. Put in the hard work, the result will then follow. Once you have put, if you are able to dedicate your time to hard work, the result will surely follow. That's the reason why a lot of traders now, they are not profitable in the market, because they don't want to put in the hard work. You're trying to explain to someone that hard work pay, but no, he's looking for someone that is going to give him or give her a robotic signal that the person. The person selling the robotic signal is a failure. He has already failed at the forex trader. So what he's trying to do is looking for people to bring together so that they have a community of failures. Because once he sells you that robotic signal, which he knows doesn't work, then you try it, you lose your money. You have also failed. So he has one client now of failure attached to him. He says to another person, he fails, so he has two now. So we now gather a community of failures. And at the end of the day, what the last word is, forex trading is not for me, or forex traders are a scam at this. So you see, it doesn't work that way. So I next week we'll be speaking more. So please subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Instagram, and see how our YouTube channel is growing. Thank you to all those that subscribe. Please share with your friends, share with everyone around you, and please like comment. Let me know what you think, what you want me to speak about more about. I get DMs and emails, so can you see much of, you can also add it on the comment section. Let us see, and then we can build a community of foresters, intelligent people. So have a lovely, lovely, lovely week. Have a lovely weekend. Please be safe out there. And we'll see you when I see you. Have a lovely weekend and bye-bye for now.